Here you see two pictures that you are probably familiar with. On the left, there's the coronavirus that has affected the whole world during 2020. And on the right, you see the iPhone that was launched by Apple in 2007 and that has disrupted the mobile phone industry and posed a serious challenge to the incumbent mobile phone manufacturers at the time. These two have something in common that you might not think. And in this talk, I will tell you what that is. So the pandemic has shown us that we live in an uncertain world. Uncertainty means that there's a lack of reliable information that is critical in identifying what decision should be made. The uncertainty that politicians face is similar to the uncertainty that business leaders face. Only after years will we know whether the decisions that have been made will be the right ones, but the decisions must be made nevertheless. So both during the corona pandemic and during the mobile phone industry in 2007, there was substantial uncertainty. Many decision makers, they initially underestimated the impact and they struggled to come up with an effective response. Now, it's always easier to see things more clearly after they happened. But it doesn't help blaming the decision makers. Instead, we should think, what can we do to improve decisions? How can we effectively deal with uncertainty at the time we face it? Here I will offer three strategies to do so. The first strategy is to use simple, but not too simple models. Here you see a picture of an S-curve that you are probably also familiar with. So you have probably seen it to show the number of corona infections over time. So during the pandemic, many people have been talking about exponential growth. But exponential growth is actually a too simple model because things cannot grow exponentially forever. And the S-curve is not quite that simple because it also includes an upper limit to growth. And there always is such a limit. And growth slows down when you get closer to the limit. But then the limit is not God-given, but it can be affected by decisions. So it is possible to shape the curve. In the pandemic, for example, through a lockdown or the use of masks, in the mobile phone industry, by competitors introducing a phone model that would be so attractive that it would reduce the momentum of the iPhone. But what the S-curve also shows is that there are very strong inherent limitations in making predictions when the S-curve is still in the early stages. So here you see different curves that have drastically different impact, but they are all but indistinguishable in the early stages. This brings me to the second strategy. When there is limited visibility into the future, you might want to think of decisions in more simple terms. Do we have a problem? Should we react? Yes or no? We are in the early stages of an S-curve, so it's possible that there's nothing to worry about and the curve will remain flat. You might have some idea how likely it is that the coronavirus will turn into a global pandemic. 50-50? 10%? 1%? Or you think that the probability that the iPhone will be a success is low? Well, even if you think that the odds are low, you still might be wrong in hindsight, so you might still want to act. So the second strategy is based on the idea that there is often a fundamental asymmetry that can be exploited, an asymmetry when decisions are made under uncertainty. There are actually two types of mistakes that you can make. So you can fail to respond if you actually should have responded, or you can act when in reality no action was necessary. And the important thing here is to realize that making one of these two mistakes is often a lot costlier than the other. So if the pandemic hits really badly, you will want to have reacted afterwards. The same thing with the iPhone. If it's successful, you will want to have reacted. So if you think it can't possibly get bad, it makes sense to act early, maybe even to overreact, even if you think it's unlikely that it will get bad. But then you also need to learn over time as more information becomes available. It's not as bad as you thought? Well, you can relax a little. But if you realize too late that it's actually very serious, it's going to be really hard to catch up, and you might have to make a desperate move, like Nokia had to do when it had failed to react to the iPhone. So what I have been talking about so far is how to react when you think there's a chance of trouble brewing. But then you might not even realize what's going on in the first place. So consider a turkey during the months before Thanksgiving. There's plenty of food, life is great. Could it be any better? Well, of course, there's something that the turkey doesn't realize. So there's a more fundamental reality. The turkey doesn't know, but of course the farmer knows. So for the turkey, there's uncertainty, a surprise in the waiting. Many people during the pandemic have been talking about the pandemic being a black swan, an unforeseeable event. Well, it's not. So plenty of people have known and they have warned us that something like that will be possible. So we have been the turkey, but we could have been the farmer. We could have known. There's a nice anecdote by Steve Jobs, the late founder and CEO of Apple. In 1996, he returned to Apple as CEO, and the company had been almost bankrupt, and he made some very drastic changes. 2 years later, in 1998, a colleague of mine, Richard Rammelt, asked Steve Jobs, "So what is your strategy? You know, Apple is a very small player in the industry, and you don't really have any advantage. So what are you going to do?" And Steve Jobs had a very surprising answer. He just said, "I'm waiting for the next big thing." And this is quite remarkable, because what it shows is that Steve Jobs was the farmer. So he had a conception of the underlying reality. So basically what he was saying is, eventually there will be another S-curve. And when it gets going, I'm going to ride it. And this is exactly what happened, first with the iPod and then later with the iPhone. So I have offered three strategies for dealing with uncertainty. The first one, to use simple but not too simple models. Second, think in terms of possible outcomes. Identify asymmetries instead of thinking about what is the more likely scenario. It might make sense to overreact early, but then also you need to adjust your response as you learn over time. And third, don't be the turkey. Understand the true situation and have a strategy. I want to end this talk with a word of caution. It's easy for me to say these things, but doing them is actually very hard in practice. So if our leaders, the politicians or the business leaders, if they get things right, then we should celebrate them. If they get it wrong, of course, we need to hold them accountable. But we shouldn't be too harsh on them. And we should assume that they have done the best they can to cope with the situation. Thank you.